Look at this, so cute guys, black on black. And you do have to turn it on. You just like pretty much, I can't do it with one hand. You just have to turn it and then literally put your finger on it and rub it just to make sure that you hear it. And then you turn it over to lock it.
With so many different things, you're working with a sphygmomanometer, you're working with the valve. There's so many different things you need to play with.
Hey everyone, so it is the next day and I want to show you guys what I got in the mail. I'm so excited, but to be honest, I needed to have this maybe 2 days ago because we had the PA assessment. Like I said in my previous vlog, we had a PA assessment which we had to manually take people's blood pressure. I was having a difficult time, guys. Like, I honestly, I did not like this. I really did not like this because I wasn't doing it right. I didn't have the stethoscope, I didn't have the blood pressure cuffs, I didn't have anything, so I hadn't practiced. So I walked into lab not knowing anything. Honestly, regretted that part. I should have been more prepared, but you know, that happens. And I walked in, you were supposed to do test blood pressures on two people and get evaluated, and within the 2 hours. I did not get anyone's blood pressure on point because you had to, like, there's like the professor has a stethoscope as well as yourself, and it's like two stethoscopes connected to one wire so that the professor can listen to the beat so that they can record the correct beat, the systolic and diastolic beat. And you have to say what it is and they have to tell you you got it or you didn't get it. You have to be plus or minus 2 or plus or minus 4 away from the actual beat. So for example, let's say I'm listening to the beat. Once the stethoscope meter starts and you hear the heartbeat, that's the systolic reading. And then once it stops, that's the diastolic reading. So for example, I see that it's at, let's say, 120, and then it stops and I see that it's at 78. So I'll tell the professor, oh, once it's done, I'll tell the professor, oh, it's 120 over 78. And she'll tell me if I was around plus or minus 2 or plus or minus 4. If you were around plus or minus 4, you end up getting a 70. If you're around plus or minus 2, you get 100. But for this PA assessment lab, just literally got check marked off. And I was so bad at doing it. I didn't know how to handle the bulb. It was a mess, a hot mess, guys. And I was feeling frustrated. I was like, I hate this part of the lab, but I'm gonna have to do it because in my rotations, clinical rotations, I'm going to need to do this because when I'm in the hospital, they're going to tell me to take these readings. And for a lot of people, it's super easy, but it does take practice, and I didn't have that practice. So this is one of the things that I do not like doing, but I'm getting the hang of it. It's super easy now that I've like got my own. And I want to show you my very first stethoscope, which I was excited to get still, even though I had a hard time doing it. I ordered both of these on Amazon and I got it literally a day later. And I'm going to show you the one I chose. Black on black. Yes, baby. Beautiful. You guys know I love my black. That's all I ever wear, black on black. And then this is just a blood pressure kit. So it matches really nicely. I'll show you guys. It comes in this case. So cute, super professional. I'm getting tested on, like graded on Tuesday. So I have, it's Saturday today. So I literally have Saturday, Sunday, Monday, 3 days to practice. My parents are coming over so I can do it on them. I've done it on Marcus, and it's just like practice, not that bad. It's just that you have to be within the same range that the professor measures it at. It's gray. I couldn't find a black one because it was sold out. This was really inexpensive. This was $12. You see side by side, it looks super nice. And this was $24. I know you can get it for a little bit cheaper, but I really like the black on black matte. Not so great at this, guys. I'm just gonna keep practicing to do better. Hopefully I can do well on Tuesday. So I've been craving a smoothie and I'm definitely influenced by Instagram.
All for the gram. Bitches love the gram.
So many people making smoothies that I started craving smoothies. Let me know in the comments down below if that ever happens to you. But I'm gonna make a smoothie. I have my coconut water. I got pineapple chunks, spinach, of course, half of a banana. And then to top it off, I'm going to do cacao nibs and maybe a little bit of powdered cinnamon on top.
Roxanne, Roxanne, all she wanna do is party all night. Goddamn, Roxanne, never gonna love me, but it's alright. She think I'm an asshole, she think I'm a player. She keep running back though, only cause I pay her. Roxanne, Roxanne, all she wanna do is party all night.
Alright guys, so I made another purchase. I actually returned the wallet that I had bought. I wasn't feeling the wallet, honestly. Ended up going to Neiman's and I got some Saint Laurent, again, espadrilles. And I just want to show you guys. So cute and super comfortable. Like, I can't wait to wear these when the weather is nicer. I've actually been eyeing espadrilles, so I was so excited for these. Super cute. Look at that. And I am normally a size 6, and a size 6.5 fit me good, but I got these in a size 7 to fit me, like, you know, extra comfortable. And they don't even look big either. I'll put them on for you. I'll show you the other pair. Like, look at that. So cute. Like, really, this is really, really cute. So, oh, and I'll show you the inside. Inside it says Saint Laurent Paris, size 37, which is 7. So comfy, guys. It doesn't look big on my feet whatsoever. And these I'm definitely keeping. Yay.